everyone, welcome back to the New Age Yogi. Today I'm going to be talking to you about a very very sacred book, which is the Bhagavad Gita. Now I'm sure that all of you must have a copy of this book. I have no doubt in my mind that people in the Hindu culture or even outside know at least about what the Bhagavad Gita is. Now the Bhagavad Gita is a spiritual text and it is something that is magnificent in its glory. Everybody actually tells you about reading the Bhagavad Gita, but today I'm going to talk to you about how to read the Bhagavad Gita whenever you're facing a problem, a challenge, or any sort of trouble in life. It is very easy to read the Bhagavad Gita cover to cover. It's very easy to derive the meaning. There are lots of translations of the book that you get everywhere. And if you do not have a copy of it, I highly recommend you to purchase one. Now, this video is not about reading it cover to cover, or if even if you've not read it cover to cover, you can make use of this video. Whenever you're in trouble and you need divine intervention, you need the God to help you, what you need to do and how to read the Bhagavad Gita and solve your problems instantly. Keep watching to find out. So the first thing that I like to do when I am reading the Bhagavad Gita is that I like to hold the book for some time, you know, just feel how it feels in your hand. Right, and just place it very very comfortably on your hand and meditate and say that God, I know you have a plan for me. I know that there are certain things that you have decided for me, and I know that I can only see a very limited amount of the future right now, and that is why I'm wanting certain things in life. However, I can only see my past and decide my present and what I need in the present moment. But you see my future and then you give me my present, right? So I would request that you give me some advice, some sign, some blessing when I open this book, and I will know that this is exactly what your plan is. And that's it. That is how you basically meditate on the Bhagavad Gita. Now, the second thing that you do is you open any random page. It doesn't have to be a certain shloka or certain chapter or certain place where you know the crux of the whole Bhagavad Gita lies. You can open any page whatsoever. Okay? Just open the page and start reading. You do not even have to read one shloka or two shlokas or three shlokas. Nothing is important. Wherever you feel you should start from, wherever you feel you should end, that is what is important for you. If you feel that you've got your answers within a certain number of pages, stop there. It's fine. You've got your answers. You've got everything. Great. Please go ahead. Close the book. Say thanks and leave it there. If you feel as if you've not got your answer, if you feel as if you still have more, you can always read as much as you want, or you can open a completely different page. But I guarantee that you will get your answer through the Bhagavad Gita. Now, going ahead, there is one step, which is that the Bhagavad Gita is basically a conversation between Krishna and Arjun, right? So whenever you see that Krishna refers to Arjun as Parth or as Dhananjay or as O Arjuna, replace that with your own name and you will find your answers. I guarantee this. This is a proven formula. And I really want to know your experiences. So please leave a comment in the comment section below. And I will be sure to reply to you guys. Thank you so much. Please do not forget to say thanks and feel grateful for the book and have some amount of reverence for this Hindu spiritual text. Thank you so much, guys. That's all for the video today. I will see you soon.